This is one of the drawbacks of leaving the bees alone for as long as you can. You know, letting the bees be bees, because if you let them be bees, they make burr comb underneath the inner cover. So these guys can definitely use a new super, more room to grow. So the last time I checked on these bees, I think there were about maybe two or three frames of bees, and now there's 9 frames of bees, except for that last one is empty. But otherwise they're pretty packed. God, I love just looking at this stuff. Look how yellow it is. This is all from the dandelion pollen and probably a little bit of coltsfoot, but man, look at this. They're just beautiful comb. Beautiful yellow comb. I love it. So I haven't looked at this frame, but I got a feeling it's full of cat brood with some nice yellow pollen. So let's take a look. Oh yeah, look at this. This is beautiful. I love it. Look at that. This is on a medium frame. Nice yellow everything. Woof. So this is beautiful too. You can see some capped brood and some holes where the bees have hatched out. And each of those holes, or most of those holes, are full of fresh eggs. So as soon as they're empty, the queen is going into town on those eggs. I love it. Just look at this brood pattern, as they call it. It's just a solid sheet of brood, and all the hatched out brood around the edges have been filled in with new eggs and grubs. So this queen is going to town. Look at this. That's smooth comb. That's capped brood. Lots of baby bees coming through. Look at that. Can you see the other? Oh yeah, you can see it. See the grubs in there? That's fresh eggs. That's 2 or 3 day old eggs. Gonna be new bees. So here's a bit of burr comb that the bees built underneath the inner cover because I didn't check on them soon enough. And I have to check for the queen, because what sucks about this is they built all this comb and the queen laid drone eggs in there. So she wasted some of her precious resources filling up comb that's never going to become bees. I'm going to have to pull it out, unless I can put it, I might be able to put this inside a frame, we'll see. But anyhow, I just got to check to see if the queen is down there. And she's not, I don't think. No. See, they don't want to abandon this because there's actually brood in there, and these are nurse bees who just don't leave the baby bees behind. See, they're all scenting. Okay, an update on old number 11. They've got another honey super. They had 2 honey supers. They were right there, and I added the green one today. And those 2 honey supers, or 2 medium supers, were either, except for maybe 2 frames, they were either full of bees or full of comb or honey, whatever. But they were packing them up pretty quick, and there's a lot of cap brood and a lot of fresh brood. So the queen is doing her thing. Hopefully I didn't screw things up, but I probably did. But I found lots of really nice cat brood up and down in both boxes, and I found a big hunk of honey over there, which I'm going to eat. So my plan was to put the third super on this today, which I did, a medium super, And those two boxes that were in on the hive already were basically filling up really fast. And they were gonna get packed really soon. If I hadn't done this today, 2 weeks from now, they would just be overloaded with bees. because I saw a lot of cap brood. And it's funny, I'm trying to judge how much cap brood I found because it's on medium frames and I'm used to looking at deeps. But anyway, lots of cap brood, nice yellow pollen all over the place and yellow wax, beautiful to look at. and the bees are just working it all out and it looks great. So basically I just added a third medium and gave them 9 more frames. And what I did too is I split the 10 frame boxes into 9 frame boxes. So I just put 9 in there because the frames, 10 frames get so tight sometimes that it's hard to pull the bees out without rolling the queen or rolling all the bees and possibly squishing bees. So I just did that for space. We'll see how that works out. But you can see one of the frames that was on the edge is pretty bulky, right? So that's the downside to that. I don't see how you can avoid that. But anyway, I'm giving it a go. I'm doing it with as many of my hives this year as I can. And the worst thing that'll happen is I'll get bulky frames of honey on the sides, which is, you know, we'll see. They've got a third medium super. But what I did is I just rearranged everything. I have some brood down there and some John Comb in between, brood here. It's all over the map. I didn't really follow my plan. I was just going to move all the brood to the bottom box and then move everything else up top. And that just didn't work out at all. I made a mess of everything in there. So they're gonna have to sort that out, but hopefully it'll be okay. And that's it. But now they've definitely got room to grow. And that's the main thing. I want to give them room to grow. I probably could have and should have, and I'll do it later, put in a completely foundationless frame so that all these bees that want to make all this extra comb got something to build. I would say I don't have to worry about this for another 2 weeks, so I'm not going to come back until probably June 20th, well, whatever 2 weeks is from now. I'll check in about 2 weeks. I don't think there's not a lot of drones yet, so there's no... swarming isn't a thing, there's lots of room, so that's it. Anyway, done. And I'm sweating like a dog. A dog's nose, anyway.